What is going on, everyone? It's Lon from the Ecom Zone, and today I'll be going through top 5 ways to retarget your customers. Let's jump into it. So there's two ways, there's a free method and a paid methods, and I'd advise you to use both of them. So some of the free methods is Klaviyo, Instagram, Pinterest, TikTok. You can also get paid ways on these channels, but they are free. Some of the paid methods is Facebook ads, Google ads, Sendinblue, and SMS Bump. But before we continue, I'd just like to say a massive thank you to those who have subscribed to my channel and to those who are actually watching my video and implementing my strategies. I hope they're helping. I know how valuable your time is and how valuable my time is. So I'll make sure to continue to post quality content that actually will make a positive impact on your business. So smash that thumbs up button, let's continue. So why retargeting campaigns and what are they? Let's just say you're running your test campaigns now and you have a 5% click-through rate, which is very high, and I'll be surprised if you did. That means 95% of your viewers will look at your ad but not click through. And so these 5% of viewers that actually click through to your website, 90% of them will actually not add anything to their cart. So we're losing 95% of viewers on your ad, and we're also losing 90% of your visitors that visit your website. That's a lot of money wasted, and with retargeting campaigns, you can draw them back into your website and hopefully they'll buy. So retargeting in a nutshell allows you to keep your brand in front of your potential customers after they have left your website. Whether that's posting on your Instagram, posting your Facebook page, running ads, Google ads, totally up to you. And with these campaigns, you're essentially persuading your potential customers to purchase. Retargeting campaigns target specific visitors with specific ads, with the goal of convincing them to convert if they haven't already. So jump into the first one. Klaviyo is a free Shopify app that if you haven't installed today, then you're missing out. As you can see on the right here, I've made a loan from Klaviyo, 90,000 last year, and I've spent nothing. There's no plans, there's no cost per email sent out, it's free. Easy to set up emails, and it requires just a teeny bit of coding knowledge to connect the email sign up to your store. So here are my free flows. Welcome series. You hit them with an introduction of your brand and a 10% coupon when they sign up. Then after 3 days, you send them an email saying, oh, you get access to blah, 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 giveaways, product releases, discounts, etc. After day 6, emotional benefits of your products. Day 9, mystery gift with maybe 20% coupon, £5 coupon, up to you. And then day 12, physical benefits of your products. And then day 15, discover a new product range on your store or discover other product ranges. The second flow that I have is abandoned carts. So after 5 minutes, I send them an issue paying email. Most of the time, customers are having issues paying, and if they receive an email that answers these questions, they're gonna convert. After 8 hours, you can send them another email. Did you forget something in your cart? Here's 10% off. After a day or two, what are you waiting for? 15% off, get it now, before you miss out. And then after day 5 or 6, you can send them an email with genuine customer reviews. What do our customers think about our products? And that's it. You can add more to this flow, it's entirely up to you, but bare minimum, you could have these 4. Also, browse abandonment, you can set this up as well. This requires a bit of coding. And the first email I send out is frequently asked questions answered. Usually customers don't buy because they have questions that are unanswered. Second email, don't miss out on this deal, here's 15% off. Third email, here are other product ranges that you may have missed out on. And that's Klaviyo. So next we have SMS Bump. SMS Bump isn't free. All you have to do is pay per SMS sent, and it costs like 5p or 5 cent. It's very cheap. And as you can see here, I spent $700 last year and I have a return on investment of 1.8k, leaving me with a revenue of 14k from SMS Bump. It does require GDPR compliance, so the setup is slightly longer than Klaviyo, but nevertheless is still good to set up. And it also requires the customer to enter their number at checkout or on your sign up form. So the welcome series, when they sign up, get introduction to the brand and 10% coupon. And then the abandoned cart flow that you can set up. After 5 minutes, they get 10% off. After 8 hours, 15% off and a reminder. Maybe they forgot about it. Maybe they were working, looking after their kids. You don't know. And then after 8 hours, it might be 9pm and it's time to buy. And then if they still don't buy, you send them another offer after 2 days. Sometimes people don't prefer the percentage off and they prefer actual value. So that it might be spend $50 and get $10 off. And to them, that is a lot more valuable than 10% off. So that's SMS Bump. Third is Facebook ads. Now Facebook ads is very complex and detailed, so I can't explain it all in this video, but I'll just speed run through it. So essentially, you're going to be setting up custom audiences on your Facebook. And these are the ones you can set up here. Page view, view content, add to carts, initiate checkouts, search, Facebook, Instagram, emails that you can import in from your Klaviyo or your Shopify, and also visitors. And you'll do this from the past 3 days, 7 days, 30 days, 90 days, and 180 days. All of them work, you just have to test them. Leave it on automatic placements, and you can also try dynamic ads with product catalog. This essentially means if a visitor checks out or looks at product A, B, and C, dynamic ads will target this user with an ad with a picture of product A, B, or C. And if you're running a carousel campaign with a catalog, then it will have item A, B, and C within the carousel. So what sort of ad copy are we looking for? We're looking for social proof. People want to trust your brand. You need some genuine reviews. Next is discounts. Maybe it's too expensive. They're looking for an extra 10% off. Here's code XYZ, use it now. Create urgency. Oh, we're running low on stock. Get it now before it's gone. Emotional benefits. Sometimes people want to understand why they're buying this product. Would it benefit them emotionally or physically? List them out on this ad. Some key points of your products, list them out. And also new products release, this is to retarget those loyal customers who purchased from you before. Ad creatives. So what sort of creative can you make? Usually you can use any. Video, carousel, images, instant experiences is entirely up to you. Try them all out. So here are my campaigns at the bottom here from Q4, so October 1st, 2020 to December 31st, 2020. And as you can see here, these campaigns are still live, they're still running, and I haven't had to touch them. They're basically on autopilot. I've spent 11k on this retargeting campaign here and made 50k. This one here, spent 6k, made 30k. The last one, retargeting, spent 8k and made 33k. And the ROAS here averages 4. So here are two companies that I always check out, Snow and the Udi. You could go on Facebook Ads Library and search for them, and all their campaigns will be there. So how to figure out if it's a retargeting campaign or a testing campaign? Usually you find it based on the copy. If the copy is like, oh, get 5% off or 10% off extra, that's a retargeting campaign. Or is there social proof or urgency, is a retargeting campaign. So yeah, you could check these out yourself. So moving on to Instagram. There's a lot of opportunity here to grow your brand and grow your audience. Brand is everything. At the end of the day, you don't want to be spending on Facebook ads without growing your organic traffic. Organic traffic is your bread and butter. The Facebook ads is just the extra on top, the ham. So Instagram, you could be posting your stories and your posts. And I advise, if you're trying to grow your Instagram page from 0 to 1,000 followers, you push out 3 stories a day and 3 posts a day, non-stop. Keep hitting your users with posts and stories so it doesn't look like your page is dead. So here are some of the stories ideas that you can post. Polls, new product announcements, product benefits, reviews, lifestyle imagery and customer testimonials. Here are some posts that you can post on your Instagram. Product ranges, lifestyle imagery, seasonal events like Christmas, Black Friday, Valentine's. And if you ever work with influencers, you can repost their posts on your Instagram. So let's go through some examples that I found on the internet. So here are some polls. You could literally be like, here's product 1 and 2, which one do you prefer? Get interactive with your customers and they'll start trusting your brand more. Second, new product announcements. It just builds up excitement for new products. Product imagery with product benefits. Look at this, built for all, built to last. Next is customer reviews with a picture of the product. Minimal design with the brand coming through, the color palettes, and promoting their products. And this is just customer testimonial on post. Get creative, guys. There's so many ways to post on your Instagram and build engagement and build followers. Last but not least, Sendinblue, an email campaign service that I use to send out bulk emails to my customers. You can use MailChimp, but Sendinblue was the cheapest for me. And these are some of the campaigns that you can be sending out. So seasonal ones, Christmas, Black Friday, Valentine's. Giveaways. Hey guys, we're running a giveaway on our Instagram, head over now. Product announcements. Oh, guess what guys, we're launching these new products on our website, check it out. Shipping delays. So if you're experiencing delays, send out a notice. Product benefits. So these are benefits of your products. Discounts. Oh, we're running a 10% discount sale now, get it now, use code blah blah blah. And I advise your email campaign to have bigger discounts than your other customers, because these guys actually signed up to your newsletter and they want some benefits, and this is one of them. More discounts. Gift guides and themed emails. And if you're struggling to design your emails, just head over to Pinterest and you could look at all their email designs by searching email campaigns inspiration, and there's a ton out there that you can get inspiration from. And that's it guys, thank you for watching. I hope this video was valuable to you, and if it was, leave it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, just drop it in the comment below. I reply to every comment. Stay tuned for more videos. Peace.